And what struck me that, now, or then, and I remember now, is my father said, you know, one time the president said, nako, itong si Ninoy, ang galing-galing ng ulo. Magpa-president ito, kaya lang malikot pa. That's what he said.
Yes.
So I think, there again, I don't think the president would eliminate somebody he respects who is brilliant enough to become president of the country.
Yes. It's all of the accounts actually discount right. Marcos as
yes.
stating something right. like that. There's a famous video of your father. I watched this when I came back in PTV4.
Okay.
When your father asked President Marcos to send in the troops.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So, back to that moment, you were there in the past,
yeah.
right? So tell me.
The events leading to that meeting with the generals by the commander-in-chief was that the RAM attacked and in fact successfully occupied the National Media Production Center.
Yes.
And there was firefighting there.
Yes.
I know because one of our soldiers is a class 71 and he reported before he was fighting back and before he realized he was fighting, he was firing at his classmates who were also class 71, Gringo being
yes.
one.
Yes.
So pretty soon he stopped firing back because he realized they were, hey, these are his classmates. So they were able to get. Then secondly, and this is the one that triggered it, General Sotelo, who was then the commanding general of the helicopter wing,
yes,
flew helicopters and they fired at us at the Malacanang grounds.
Right.
And they fired at least a dozen rockets.
Okay.
One rocket hit a platoon of Marines. And I was at the hospital, I saw two of them, one without a leg and the other one without an arm. And I don't think they survived it, but we sent them to Biluna anyway. My presidential guards, I got hit on two posts, guard posts, and one officer who happened to be patrolling around, and he got hit on his palm. My mother, because we have our quarters in Malacañang, when the bombing came, I telephoned, said, better leave. Because I knew they might come back again.
Yes.
And so, he was about to leave, but she was still grabbing her stuff.
Yes.
The driver has already started the engine, the car roaring, and the bombs came. It hit the car of my mother. There were maybe more than a dozen shrapnels into the car. My father then said, all right, we have reached a situation where we are in a combat phase. So he called upon the Joint Chief of Staff,
yes.
the operations, the training, all of them. And they recommended, we have to counterattack. We cannot just sit down. We cannot just let our troops suffer and accept the bullets. We have to fire back. Mm-hmm. The president, so my father asked for a meeting with the commander-in-chief.
Right.
So that was the scenario.
That's
then.
The video, yeah.
So the president comes in a little groggy because he was sick at the time and said, Don't fire. Remove your bullets in your rifles. Just point at them to show that we still have rifles. Those were the things. So my father said, "No, Mr. President." He felt that the president could not grasp the situation. So that's when my father stood up, and he said, "Mr. President, it is time that we have to counterattack." That was what he said. That's what I can remember that what she said. And of course the president said no right away.
that now we are talking about the problem in the South China Sea, popularly known as Spratly. If President Marcos did not have that power, and he had the guts and the boldness to do what he felt was necessary, the Philippines would not be talking of any claim there. This claim came about only when Admiral or Cloma, we call him Admiral at the time, discovered, he says discovered, but the point is they were uninhabited at the time to cover these islands, and he went to President Marcos because the Chinese were already threatening to overcome him. And he said, Mr. President, I am willing to cede all of this to the Republic of the Philippines, provided I retain private ownership. Where Marcos said, no, you cede them, but you do not retain private ownership. So right then he told me, prepare the decree by which we declare these islands as belonging to the Philippines, and we constitute them as a municipality, part of the province of Palawan. That is how it started. Well, just among us, no study, no research, just declare, and without that, there would be no claim at all. So it was my task after that to find historical basis for the claim as well as legal basis. Incidentally, in order to determine whether there were historical foundations, I availed of professors of history of the University of the Philippines.
Natin si Laguna Governor E.R. Ejercito. Governor Ejercito, magandang gabi po.
Yes. Kung tinuloy yung panahon ni Pangulong Ferdinand Marcos na dinisenyo ni Architect John Palabox, siguradong hindi po babaha sa Metro Manila at saka dito sa Rizal at saka sa lalawigan ng Laguna.
Ang kabilin-bilinan ko kay Mrs. Corazon Aquino ay pagpatuloy ang Bataan Nuclear Plant kung maaari. Sapagkat I told her this is the solutions in meeting a country's energy demands and decreasing dependence on imported oil. Ngunit ayaw niyang tanggapin ang aking mungkahi. At maaalala daw ng taong bayan si Marcos habang andiyan ang Bataan Nuclear Plant. Anong klaseng pag-iisip yan? Ayan ay paghihiganti. Huwag na idamay sa buhay ng Pilipino. Kanya te, balang araw, makikita ninyo, 20 years from now, backstock na ang Pilipinas.
Kasama mga madre, binigilan mga tangke. Umiiyak ka pa sa harap ng mga sundalo. Namigay ka pa ng rosas na nabili mo sa kanto. Kumusta na? Ayos pa ba ang buhay natin? Kaya pa ba? Eh kung hindi, paano na? Ewan mo ba? Bahala na. Dala-dala mo pa estatwa ni Saturnino, eskapulario at biblia, sang natutak na rosario.
at sa gitna ng EDSA, lumuhod ka't nagkasal pa. Our Father, Hail Mary, from the bounty through Christ our Lord, Amen. Kumusta na? Ayos pa ba ang buhay natin? Kaya pa ba? Eh kung hindi, paano na? Ewan mo ba? Bahala na. Pebrero 26, nang si Apo ay umalis. Ibi mo'y hanggang tenga, nakakatalon, napunit pang pantalon mo. Pero hindi bale, sabi mo, marami naman kami. Kahit na amoy pawis, tuloy pa rin ang disco sa kalye. Kumusta na? Ayos pa ba ang buhay natin? Kaya pa ba? Eh kung hindi, paano na? Ewan mo ba? Bahala na. Nakita kita kahapon, may hila-hilang kariton. Huminto sa may Robinson, tumangabong maghapon. Sikat ka noon sa TV, kasi kasama ka doon sa rally. Pero ngayon nag-isa, naglalakad sa may EDSA. Kumusta na? Ayos pa ba ang buhay natin? Kaya pa ba? Eh kung hindi, paano na? Ewan mo ba? Bahala na. Kumusta na? Ayos pa ba ang buhay natin? Kaya pa ba? Eh kung hindi, paano na? Ewan mo ba? Bahala na. Ewan mo ba? Bahala na.